have you realized that you've already made it? A point brought up by Eddie Bravo and Joe Rogan. And I like Eddie Bravo much more than Joe Rogan. I thought that was an excellent point. Because Eddie was reviewing how grateful he is that he's a failed rock star, a failed musician, and just wonders what sort of tailspin he would have gone under had he made it in the world of Hollywood. Or made it, or have accomplished the idea of making it. You know, when I see some of these motherfuckers that say, you know, I want to be an actor. Think of a friend of mine who had a rough childhood. And fucking gangstered out to upbringing. Is he a friend or a homie? More of a homie. Times I encountered him were funny. Friend, homie of a friend, friend of a friend. But seeing this dude on television series and movies, and knowing him in the civilian world before a lot of that shit kicked off. When I see him in the movies, I think of his history. That acting is real. It's based off of an experience somewhere, or his emotion, or witnessing someone's emotion. And to make it, what does that mean? Because even if you earn $1 million or $1 billion, will you only be reacting or behaving in a way that the music video tells you how to get a mansion, get buy diamonds and a fast car? And me, I do struggle with this this idea, because In a world of capitalism, I'm trying to think what it was. Was it Mark Cuban who said that in the game of capitalism, you keep score with the amount of money? No, I like that. Fuck socialism, fuck democratic socialism, fuck communism. Those are all just systems for the weak, pussified motherfuckers out there, lazy motherfuckers, weak cucks that don't want to hold themselves accountable, don't see the beauty in the moment. And are just little weenies, man. Thinking of this one piece of shit old man that I ran into more than once. Oh man, I got a dog just like that. And out of the dozen plus times I've seen him walking down the street, I've never once seen him walk any sort of dog. And I'm thinking, wow, you must be a real piece of shit owner, man. Versus somebody else who keeps your dog locked on nice and tight, safe from other dogs, because doesn't know if the other dog's friendly or nice. Needs to be dewormed or defleed, and is out watching it. I've even seen this old man fight or argue with a parking enforcement, and thinking, well, as much as I think that parking enforcement is also a racket, it's the rules, man. And if you save up and live on a farm and shut the fuck up, you could do that. You could fucking park your car upside down and sit in it with your fucking dick hanging out, and no one's gonna give a fuck. But if you're here in the city, hey, play by the city rules. And what else should we have read? I'm going to be picky right here, because I have some room temperature coffee next to me, bottled water that I haven't finished. I think they opened this bottle yesterday, so it's not fresh. And this chair could be a lot more cushion. Could have a lot more cushion, a lot more comfortable, and I can get into the state of mind of, you know what, I deserve an ice chilled, freshly blended frappuccino delivered to me. I should get some ice cold Evian water. Yes, Fiji water better. I deserve it. Oh my goodness, I can't work on this chair. And I could think such things and complain, and I don't get it, man. I don't get that sort of thinking. But the more and more miserable cunts that I run into, the more I think, oh my goodness, I really, really have not made it. Or even I think, you know what, I need to make a lot of money so you get that gated community, get that farm, that fucking bunker, that fucking zombie-proof encampment, or some shit like that. Sometimes people think that I may be exaggerating on some of the things that I say, but many times I told people, stop. Look to your left. Check that out. My 6 o'clock. My 3 o'clock. Check it. And it's a real life cartoon character in action. But we've made it, man. got running water, good. If you got running cold and hot water, even better. If you got a fridge, good. If you got a fridge with a freezer, even better. If you have a fridge and a freezer with food in it, you're good. If you have shoes on, you're good. If you're comfortable, awesome. If they're new and comfortable, and they're your favorite color, even better. If you can stand up and run in any direction that you want, even better. All these little things are just, markers that that say that you have made it, man. And our dumbasses, including me, say, man, can't things get any better? Why don't I get rocket shoes, flying shoes? So be careful on who you hang out with, because, you know, there's a big difference between someone saying, you know what, dog, you know what, girl, this is good, but you could do better, versus, nah, no way, you deserve more. You know, they're only hating on you because you're a woman, because you're a man, because you're transgender. You're a brown, Latino, nigger, faggot, big nose Jew, Crocodile Dundee, I don't fucking know. You walk like a wombat. I should get some more red, but... Someone motivating you or reminding you of your motive. Helping you focus, sharpen your motive, and between someone else egging you on and telling you to, oh, you should be a fool, fuck that. Let's just rebel because we didn't get the toys that we wanted. As much as I do not want to admit this, I have to say that it's true that I've designed the number of zeros, the number of digits, and what those digits are in my bank account. Whether they're high or low. And it would be not just foolish, stupid, and small thinking to say, no, it's not my fault, it's your fault. Gives me some money, yo. That's it for now.